Minister, Ambassador, Generals, ladies and gentlemen. As we all know, Europe faces a more complex, unpredictable and challenging security environment than in decades, including increasingly assertive Russia. We have concretely seen the changes in our vicinity. The military importance of the Baltic Sea region has increased and the military activity intensified. At the same time, our adversaries can easily move from low level of conflict and hybrid warfare to conventional battle. Being military non-aligned does not insulate Finland from these changes. We share the same security and we share the same operational environment. Finnish defense policies fundamentals derive from our location between West and East. Experiences of the Second World War are not forgotten in Finland. Geopolitics has still a strong influence on our foreign and security policy. Russia has been and will be the most significant actor and factor in our security environment. Finland implements an active defense and security policy to prevent military threats. We do not have the option or even desire to isolate ourselves from our operating environment. I believe that Finland, as a member of the European Union, could not remain an outsider if a military crisis emerged in our vicinity. Yet, we do not see any direct or imminent military threat against Finland at the moment. However, we cannot exclude the possibility of the use of military force against us. Therefore, Finland takes its own defense very seriously. Finland's national defense provides deterrence and contributes to the security and stability of the Baltic Sea region. While many other countries in Europe after the Cold War shifted to smaller, lighter professional forces suited to expeditionary crisis management operations, our defense forces have maintained a large reserve force based on conscription and focused on territorial defense. Some were wondering why Finland stubbornly maintained such a sizable military force. I haven't heard such comments lately. The cornerstones of our national defense are general conscription, a credible defense that covers the entire country, and active international defense cooperation. The foundations of our national defense is the strong will of our citizens to defend our country. As my four-year term as a Minister of Defense is almost over, it is time to assess how well we have succeeded in maintaining our defense. The change in the security environment was acknowledged in the current government program and defense report. The latter emphasized the need to develop the military capabilities correspondingly with the increasing demands of the security environment. Improving the readiness of all services, especially that of the armies, has been our priority since 2014. Training of conscripts for the new readiness units was started in the beginning of 2018. Legislative measures were made to allow rapid mobilization of reserves. The defense budget was increased annually by 50 million euros allocated especially to improve readiness. The material readiness of all services has been improved through several programs. New capabilities like K9 Thunder self-propelled howitzers and counter-battery radars are being introduced. We have signed contracts for new rockets and missiles for the Army and Navy, improving our joint fires capabilities. Cyber defense capabilities are being developed as well as intelligence capabilities. The brand new Act on military intelligence has been approved, extending our intelligence also to include cyberspace. Our key capability programs, which aim to replace the outfacing capabilities of the Navy and the Air Force, are on track. The funding for Navy's 4 multi-purpose corvettes is already included in the defense budget, and we will soon sign the contracts for shipbuilding and combat systems. The quotations for our new multi-purpose fighter program were received from all 5 candidates by the end of January this year, and they are currently being analyzed. The next government will decide in the year 2021 which will be our next fighter. There is already a cross-parliament consensus about replacing fully the capabilities for our outfacing Hornet fleet. In practice, this means at least 64 new fighter planes. Over the years, especially after the Cold War, Finland reduced the amount of wartime forces. But now we have changed the course. For the first time since the Cold War, we have increased the wartime strength of our defense forces by some 50,000 soldiers. The total wartime establishment is now some 280,000 soldiers, of which some 97% are reservists. In order to strengthen our general conscription system, we have launched a new program to develop the training system of conscripts and reservists. We have also recently approved an act that will better integrate some elements of our volunteer national defense training to the defense forces. Legislative measures to respond to changes in the security environment are numerous. I have already mentioned some of them. In order to be better prepared for hybrid threats, we have introduced legislative changes to tackle the so-called little green men, problematic foreign ownership of estates, challenges of dual citizenship in security organization, and drones in the vicinity of military installation, just to mention a few of them. I have spoken about our national defense, but have not yet mentioned one element of it, that is international defense cooperation. We play an active role in enhancing EU's defense dimension, and we are a close partner to NATO. And then we, of course, have the Nordic defense cooperation, the Nordefco, and we are in the UK-led Joint Expeditionary Force, the JEF, and the French-led European Intervention Initiative, EI2. And this government has concluded many bilateral and multilateral defense cooperation arrangements with our partners, actually 10 of them altogether. Participation in international defense cooperation serves Finland's interests, and we believe it serves our partners' interests too. The capability to receive military assistance is also an important part of defense. Peacetime cooperation lays the foundation for cooperation during crisis. This kind of defense cooperation is not to be based on treaty obligations, but on shared common interests. We are ready to defend Finland, and it benefits our partners that we can do it effectively. Ladies and gentlemen, to sum up, the old threats remain and new threats emerge. The demands for defense have grown. As I said, Finland has always taken defense in a very serious manner. Thanks to the decisions we have made nationally, Finnish defense forces are more capable than ever in the peacetime. We will continue to take utmost care of our defense capability also in the future. The fundamentals of the Finnish defense policy remain. The main focus has been and still is on our national defense. We need to strengthen our defense capability and intensify our international defense cooperation. Together we can provide stability in the Baltic Sea region, and I'm convinced this is the right way